Now, I gotta have the right page. I don't have the words quite memorized yet. When it's late December, dark and cold, where is the light? Wow.
Yeah.
That was good. When all that year is bending low, where is the light? When the sun runs off to bed too soon, where is the light? And there's nothing but a skinny moon, where is the light? During the service,
red roses were handed out to all of her fathers. So today, in keeping with that, I have brought you all some red roses. So after service, make sure you see me, and I will give you the rose. And they're actually pretty cool. They're wooden. So I thought that was kind of neat. You know, although this is the story of how the U.S. developed Father's Day, many cultures celebrate Father's Day. And I was looking into it, and I thought I would share a few with you. As you know, in the U.S., we typically spend Father's Day by grilling out or spending time outdoors. In Mexico City, they hold a 13-mile run for the fathers, and then they celebrate afterwards with yummy treats. In South Africa, children will spend the day fishing in hopes of catching dinner for their fathers. In Japan, they give their fathers personalized sandals and candies, and then they have a special seafood dinner. So in most cultures, you know, fathers are honored by spending time with their families and having meals, exchanging gifts, and really expressing their gratitude, their respect. Except in Germany. I thought this was pretty funny. In Germany, they declare it's a no women allowed day. And they hike up to the mountains, often carrying wagons filled with alcoholic beverages.
Yeah!
Right?
Yep.
So.
And accordions.
I haven't seen this happen, but maybe accordions. So thank you all fathers for being here. We acknowledge you today. Now, in case you haven't noticed, the past few weeks that I've been up here giving the talks, I've kind of created June to be Mindfulness Month. So the very first talk, we talked about mindful observation with the tangerines. And last week, we talked about mindfulness for busy people. So today, I thought it'd be appropriate to talk about mindful appreciation. Now, there's many designated days of appreciation. Right? I think most traditional holidays are designated days of appreciation. So like Valentine's Day is meant to honor the people we love. And for those of you who know me personally, you know that I love love. I'm a lover. And I just never really understood why we had to have one day to designate to love. Or to fathers or mothers or veterans, you know, whatever it may be, whatever that traditional holiday is. And so that's what I really like about mindful appreciation, is because, you know, it allows us to be aware and appreciate each other on a daily basis rather than a designated day. Not that it's bad to have a designated day by any means, but, you know, everyday living is what's more powerful, meaning to us, right? So, how do we acknowledge appreciation? Gratitude. We're a gratitude ministry here, aren't we? And gratitude really breeds appreciation. So, in your bulletins, there's these grateful treats, I like to call it, three different blanks for you to fill out. And I want you to think about what you're grateful for. Unity, of course, right? To be thankful for or grateful for your friends, your family, could be a new car, job, a new house, right, Chuck? Yeah.
I need more than three.
Good. I'm glad you need more than three. So, you know, but the house and the family and friends, you know, that's all the obvious stuff. So, what if you go deeper with that and really consider the things that you're grateful for that you might not necessarily appreciate all the time? I think of things like the greenness of spring and summer, or the way the grass feels under my bare feet. I love that. Maybe it could be the feel of cool water on a hot day. These are things that we appreciate, but we kind of take for granted sometimes. So when you're filling out already filled yours out, use that as an opportunity to look at them and say, you know, are these the obvious gratitudes, or did I go a little deeper with it? And if you did that, you can always change it. Share it, you can write it on the back, you can fill it out. There's no such thing as too much gratitude. When you're all done filling those in, I'm going to actually have you use that to help you with our exercise today. Just one minute to get those in there. Okay, so we'll go ahead and get started. So today's exercise is really a journey to the Grateful Garden, is like what I like to call it. And how it works is, I'm going to take a little journey to the Grateful Garden. And on my way there, I may encounter some challenges, such as true of life, right? And when I get to these challenges, I may need your help. And so when I need your help, I'm going to signal by giving the peace sign. And when I do that, I want you to yell out one of your gratitudes. And that will make me happy again, so that I can get back on track. Everybody ready for the journey?
Let's do it.
All right. If I don't fall off the stage, and I'm sorry if you don't get me on the camera.
I got you.
Okay, thanks. All right, so we're on our way to the Grateful Garden. And we're just journeying around here, enjoying the walk, enjoying the day. And as we're on our journey to the Grateful Garden, we first encounter the frowny forest. I feel grumpy now. Frowny forest. Having a bad day. Got up, stubbed my toe, got out of bed. The whole day just seems to be going like that. How do I not be grumpy? I know.
Food day!
Oh, yeah.
Thank you! Oh, you know, it's really hard to be grumpy when you're grateful. So, let's continue on. So we're almost to the Grateful Garden. And gratitude and appreciation, we can enjoy the journey and ultimately the destination. I'd like to say that life isn't always easy. In life, we have to travel through some of the challenges and the tough roads that make us feel many things like grumpy, sad, or even mad. But having that gratitude helps set you back on the right path again and gets us where we need to be. So that way, when we're appreciating what we have rather than what we don't have, then we can always keep going on the right path and be genuine and mindfully appreciative in our lives. So the last thing I really have is, how do we incorporate more gratitude in our lives, in our day-to-day lives? How do we do that? And I think the simple daily exercise of writing down the 3 things that you're grateful for, you know, you might not have somebody there to say, hey, here's, you know, I'm shouting stuff at you. But you can always go back to your own gratitudes. And I think that's an effective way of improving the gratitude and appreciation in our lives. Mindfully. So it is.
I can feel God's mighty power and God's feel the energy that's in our body. We become aware of the warmth and tingling of every cell. We feel the energy that is in the extended environment, in every part of nature, and in every living thing. We bring all of those energies together and feel them as one. Now we visualize all of that energy shining brightly as the sun, bringing the shining glow of bright energy over.
energy and light going down into your chest, all the way down to your hips. Feel it continue traveling down your legs, all the way to your toes. The whole body is now filled with the divine healing light and energy. Allow that healing energy to completely fill any physical areas that need healing energy. Feel it blending, healing, and expanding through those areas. Allow the healing light to bring peace and healing to any emotional issues or traumas. Now bring your awareness to any intention and desires that you may have. Hold the thoughts of those intentions or desires as you allow the healing energy to bring your deepest desires to life and your intentions into reality. Feel your connection to divine energy and light, and know that all is one. As you come back to the room, and gently open your eyes, give yourself a little stretch. And remember this deep, relaxing, peaceful feeling.